Hello, this is Daniel. Apologize, I'm posting this a day late. I am out in the middle of nowhere visiting my father for Father's Day, and we had a little trouble getting on the router because my dad lost the password, which is really not a surprise at all for my dad. Anyway, so I spoke to the same person that I had written my cover letter to, that is a person that I've known for a very long time that works in this field. And I hadn't spoken to them for a long time and kind of touched base since all this was going on. And I started thinking about any resources that I would have that would be close by, attainable, people that would know, networking, as we call it. And so I reached out to this person. That was why I ended up constructing my cover letter to them, which they reviewed also and said it was a little bit over the top, but for like a school assignment, it was pretty decent because it had all the things in there and it did get a little bit repetitive, which I totally understood, but I left it as it was after they looked at it and I handed it in that way. But I expressed what I said in my last video about the proof being in the pudding. As they say, most of my job experience, my career experience, I've gotten my jobs just based on reputation and people seeing me do what I do and, like, you know, being able to prove my work. And I expressed this concern coming into a new field with the person that I was speaking with, and they told me something they're pretty interesting. They were like, they told me, like, Dan, you're doing it right now. Since we've been talking, you've mentioned at least three authors that we both have read and admire. You've brought up however many current events that are prolific to what we're working on right now. You expressed interest in work that I had done. Like, if I sat down in an interview with you for this position, you would be hitting all these marks just by being yourself. And then they stopped me again and they were like, that's the thing. Like, when you go into something like this with, like, the kind of passion and vigor that you're approaching this with, and the amount of just, like, practical experience that you have, like, if you have enough to just get your foot in the door and get somebody face to face with you, or to read something that you actually wrote and thought up yourself, you should be okay with them getting them to listen to you a little bit further. And then if you do that and have done a little bit of homework on the person that's going to be interviewing you and come up with a couple of the common things, like you hit with me on accident, maybe on purpose. And I really thought about that for a minute, and I was like, that totally makes sense, because it shows all those things, the analytical thinking, the critical thinking, the research, use of language, communication skills, all that stuff comes through just in doing that. So it really drove home to me just how important just like the interview process is, and just like the get to know you in this type of field can really be the meat and potatoes of how you do what you do. It can be that is like the proof in like those types of interactions, and of course decent grades and some writing samples and such. But it was a really decent experience, and I feel it's a little bit unfortunate that what I applied for is not actually something that they are looking for, but it is something that they're looking for occasionally. And this person, that's how they actually got their foot in the door with the same organization, with the guild. Overall, it was a very positive experience, because after you saw my last video, I didn't really expect someone to just like give me what kind of seemed like a golden ticket to it and let me feel like I was really making the right choices and presenting myself the right way already. So I learned a lot, and it was very interesting, and I thank you very much for the opportunity, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.